Memento mori. To begin depriving death of its greatest advantage over us, let us adopt a way clean contrary to that common one. Let us deprive death of its strangeness. Let us frequent it. Let us get used to it. Let us have nothing more often in mind than death. We do not know where death awaits us, so let us wait for it everywhere. To practice death is to practice freedom. A man who has learned how to die has unlearned how to be a slave. Michael de Montaigne. How bad can all this spiritual stuff get? What's the worst case scenario? These can be very scary and paralyzing questions to leave open-ended, especially when we set out alone on a journey beyond the charted regions of the map. The answer to these questions, happily, is death. Death is as bad as it can get. Death is the worst-case scenario. That's where this whole thing ends up. That's the full extent of the downside. You are going to die. And of course, you're going to die anyway, so it's really kind of a non-issue. I have always found this simple observation both comforting and empowering. My own journey was made possible by having that question, how bad can this really get, neatly tied off at the end. Death is absolute. Unlike anything else in the dream state, death is clearly seen and certainly known. It is where we are going, whether we take this journey or not. No matter what you do, no matter how horrible it gets, it doesn't just keep getting worse and worse forever. There's an end to it. And since I'm going to die anyway, and it's only a matter of when, the simple fact is that it really can't get bad at all. This casual treatment of death is not meant to minimize the agony of peeling off your skin in layers as you divest yourself of emotional content and connections. That's the gruesome part. But the fact is that these wounds heal instantly. Rather, no wound remains. Gone is gone. Done is done. With every step we leave behind that which we move beyond. No baggage is carried because releasing baggage is the essence of progress. The pain-giving thing is the thing removed. When it's gone, so is the pain. All that's left in its place is relief and a mild, short-lived curiosity. It's like pulling a bad tooth or ripping off a bandage. The tough part is the fear before and the pain during. There's no phantom limb syndrome haunting us after we've amputated a gangrenous piece of emotional meat. There's just a pleasant nothing until a new pain announces itself and the next cycle begins.